Welcome to Bismart Together. I mainly focus on Power Query and Excel. If you're new, please subscribe and turn on the notification. Also, feel free to drop a comment to give feedback, ask questions, or let me know if there are any topics you're interested in.
Hey KT, I'm trying to use the List.Zip function in Power Query, but I'm not sure how it works. Can you help me out?
Sure thing. The List.Zip function is used to combine two lists into one list of pairs. The pairs contain one item from each list, and the resulting list has the same number of items as the shorter of the two input lists.
Okay, that makes sense. Can you show me an example?
Sure. Let us go through a simple example. We have a group list, product list, quantity list, and price list. Say you need the sales amount, that is price multiplied by quantity. How can we do that? One of the common approaches is adding a custom step, replacing the highlighted curd with an empty list. Adding the group list, product list, quantity list, and price list within the empty list. Then, we use the table.fromColumn function to convert the lists to a table. Once you turn the lists into a table, you can select the price and quantity columns and use the multiply function to get the sales amount. However, you may not want to convert it into a table if you're still in the transformation, as transforming through the list function is faster than the table function. Update the highlighted function to the List.Zip function. Preview each of the zipped list. Before we zip the list, we have a group list, product list, quantity list, and price list as individual list. The List.Zip function transformed those lists by pairing items from the same row into a list. You now have each row of the group list, product list, quantity list, and price list grouped into a list. Delete the highlighted lists. Then, use the List.Transform function to calculate the sales amount, taking the first item on the sublist and multiplying it with the second item on the sublist. Now you can add a custom step, turn the sales list into a sublist. Add the other four lists into the list. And then use the TableFromColumn function, converting the list into a table.
Got it. That's a simple example. Can you give me a more common use case?
Sure. One common use case is to handle multi-headers. Let's look at the sales report. We have year, month, and transaction type, so we have three rows of headers. Switch over to the Power Query editor, and I will show you how to use the List.Zip in this case. First, let's start by adding a custom step and naming it header list, and then update the highlighted in the formula bar with a nested let expression, set list by row equal to source and in list by row. Let's properly indent the code. Now add the table to row function as highlighted, converting each row into a list. Add the second variable, header list, and use the list first end to get the first four items on the list, which are the header. The first row is the title, and we don't need it. Use the list skip function to skip the first row, and then preview the three sublists. If you look at the year, it didn't fill down to each row, and we need to fill down the list. Firstly, add a substep and use the list position function to get the position on the first sublist. Then, we want to use the list accumulate function to loop through the list. Set A equal to the first list. When we loop through the list and check if the value is not null, then add the value to the accumulator as a list. Otherwise, we want to return the last value from the accumulated list. Here you go. We want to use the output step, converting the output to a sublist and appending it with the original header list. Preview the sublist, you will see the original sublist containing the year list. Use the list skip function to skip it. Add another custom step and name it zipped. Now, add the List.Zip function to the formula bar as highlighted. Preview the result for the first few items, and the sublists are now converted by pairing up the item from each of the previous lists into a list. We can now use the List.Transform function, transforming the list by using the textCombine function to combine the text. We got errors. The reason we got errors was because the list contained non-text value, the year value. To overcome the problem, we need to use the list.Transform and textFrom functions to convert the number to text. Now, we have the multi-header column name list ready. Add a custom step and name it insert header. To insert a row, we want to use the tableInsertRow function. The first argument is a table, the source step is the table in this case. The second argument is the row number where we want to insert. The last argument's requirement is the data structure must be in record type in a list. We can use the recordFromList function to convert a list to a record. The second argument is the column name. Here you go. Now, you can promote it to the header. Then, remove the top four rows. Unpivot other columns other than the first one. Then, use the split column function to split the selected column by delimiter. Instead of the usual way to rename the column, you can rename the column in the formula bar as highlighted.
That's helpful. Can you show me an example of that in action?
Certainly. In a recent Power Query challenge, one of the experts used the list.zip function as part of the solution for transforming the serial column. I have attached the file with commentary. Please feel free to go through it and drop me a message if you have any questions.
Wow, that's really useful. Thanks for explaining it to me.
You're welcome. Remember, the list.zip function is a powerful tool for combining lists and creating new tables with related data paired together. With the right strategies in place, you'll be able to use it effectively in your data analysis and Power Query projects. Thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful. Please don't forget to click like if you like the video.